So a few days ago, I got a comment saying that make a tutorial on hair simulation like Jelex Rosa. Well, Jelex Rosa was a new name for me. So I searched that on YouTube and watched almost all of his video, and my reaction was like,
holy moly, it's alive.
And then I thought I should create that myself. So I made this. So first of all, it's time to get the costumes done. So I used some very expensive custom made costumes like I always do. And then I shot the footage with a green screen behind my character. The first thing to do was to get the skull model, because I was trying to get some Ghost Rider kind of look. So that I downloaded it from free3d.com, and now it's time to get the head tracked. So let's start tracking the head. Tracking the head was really simple. I went to the Blender's object tracker and tracked some basic details of the face like eyebrows, mustache, nose and all. After tracking, I let Blender to solve the object's motion. After solving, I applied a camera solver constraint on my camera and an object solver constraint on my object. And after the location was tracked, I added some manual rotational keyframes on the skull to match its rotation with my character's head. And after the semi-automatic, manual, whatever tracking was done, the results were pretty good. Now it's time to simulate the hair. To simulate the hair, I added simple hair particle system on my skull and checked the hair dynamics option. And then I added some force fields like wind and turbulence to create that wavy hair effect. Now the most fun part, adding the fire. To add the fire, here I cheated a little bit. I used this asset and slapped it on my skull and gave it a displacement modifier with a cloud texture to get a bit of 3D look. Look at it. Who can say it's 2D except me? And then I rendered it out in cycles. I used cycles because it looks better for some reason. Now all the CG things are done, let's prepare our footage. So the first thing we need to do is to remove our head. To remove our head, I just created a simple mask around my character's neck and changed the mode to subtract. And I also masked out a small part of the shoulder and animated it to use it at the empty part behind the neck. And you can see, we successfully removed our head. So finally we got our skull after 6 hours of rendering, so let's use it on our footage. So compositing of skull was really simple. Just drag and drop your skull onto your footage and yeah, you are done. You can also match some colors if you want, but mine works fine. Just look at it. We are almost done. Now the last thing, the background. I created a full 3D scene in Blender to use as a background, which took me 2 days of regular work. And the results were also pretty awesome, as you can look at it, but I couldn't render even one frame in EV, so I had to drop the idea. So let's jump over to the final compositing, using this stock footage for the background. So first of all, let's 3D track our footage into After Effects, cause it's the fastest 3D tracking software I believe. After tracking, I added my Ghost Rider footage in the scene by converting it into a 3D layer. And I also hided his legs by using a rock which I masked out from the scene itself. Now let's turn on the layers one by one. After compositing, I added some elements like lens flares, fire, some more lens flares, and yeah, look at it. It's very satisfying to watch it like this. And at last, the lastest step, I added a simple overall grade and glow, and the result were like this.
Mistake. That's Obito Uchiha.
So we made it up to the end of the tutorial, and I hope you liked that video. Now you must be wondering that why there is a 1 month gap between my previous 2 videos. So let me tell you that the last month was very busy for me. I had to change my school, I had to shift from Bihar to Chandigarh. So yeah, I hardly get any time to make videos last month. But don't worry, now we are back in the flow and the next video is coming. The next tutorial is coming on this, so make sure to subscribe.